Hey guys, this is Alachia, and this is kind of a soda cooler chat. I am doing soda today because that's just what I normally do, actually, anyway. So, mix half of Diet Dr. Pepper and half of Diet Barks Root Beer. Am I saying that right? I don't know. Anyways, that is my concoction that I normally drink. And I just wanted to do like a little sort of chat about the casting choice for Tilda Swinton in Doctor Strange, which I discussed in my Q&A. And I said I didn't really understand Marvel's choice on that. And because I had read a couple articles about why Marvel chose to choose a female, white female, to play a Tibetan monk, a male Tibetan monk. And it never really clicked. And I got these comments because my subscribers are awesome and smart as fucking hell. And I felt really dumb after I read them because I was just like, oh yeah, duh. All right, so Christian Jadot commented and said, one last thing. The Ancient One was changed race because of the Chinese market and the Chinese government's attitude towards even the slightest mention of Tibet. And then Zhang Wernan said, I heard they picked Tilda Swinton over an Asian actor because the monk is Tibetan, and that wouldn't sit well in China. And not to offend anyone, they picked someone who would appear more ambiguous. Yeah. Thank you, guys. Thank you for pointing out the freaking obvious to me that I completely missed. And yes, it makes sense, right? You know, China has a very, very strong ban on any sort of media that represents Tibet in a good light. It has been since the 50s, if you want to believe it, which I do, the basically genocide, as they have tried to basically incorporate Tibet under China. They are part of the People's Republic of China, and stop. That is their position, and anyone who goes kind of against that or represents, you know, Tibet in a good light is considered something that they would ban. And when I looked at the actual numbers for Disney Marvel and what the numbers produce in China, you would think it's not that big a deal. I think the biggest one was $240 million for Age of Ultron. It's probably one of their highest. Even like The Force Awakens was only $124 million. You know, I think Germany produced more for box office numbers in terms of foreign box office numbers for Marvel. However, if you look at the overall picture, China is very, very sensitive about these types of things, and they don't take offense very well. Just look at 7 Years in Tibet, which was a film with Brad Pitt, and they banned him from entering China for 10 years. Richard Gere, who had been largely sympathetic towards the Tibetan cause and bringing light to a lot of the human rights violations, all his films are banned there. So it's this really sensitive subject. And yes, while I reach this sort of aha moment, you start to think, well, what is the price? What is the price of including China in our global marketing economy for film? Does Marvel have a responsibility, or is this, you know, it's business, it's not personal, you know, right? And when you look at it from a movie by movie standpoint, like what is Doctor Strange actually going to add up to in China? Probably not that much. Maybe, let me see, like at best, I'm guessing around 86 million. But that's a very conservative number. But you have to look at what the overall effect would be if they were to piss off China. Marvel is owned by Disney. Disney is a giant corporation. Toy Story did very huge there. And a lot of the, you know, a lot of the animated films do very, very well there. And for China to say, hey, you know what? We're just not going to allow Disney in. You know what? You guys, fuck you, and we're not gonna show your films. And that would be billions and billions of dollars over the course of many years, for however long they decided to ban them, that eats into their profits. And then that's where I start to have those questions where I go, what is personal responsibility with any sort of business or studio, right? Is everything about money? And that's a really huge question. If you look at YouTube and you look at people who want to make money on YouTube, I haven't figured out if I want to do that yet or, you know, how I want to do that. But the allure of money is a huge one. Greed is a very natural instinct, a life instinct, not just in humans, you know, and that propels us to compromise integrity. And I know you guys have seen this all over YouTube, especially, you know, so people, when they're presented with X amount of money, have to say, well, what's the harm, right? What's the harm in promoting X product or not promoting X product for X amount of money? But then you multiply that and you multiply that and you go like, well, when is it not about money? And I don't really fault Marvel or Disney for looking at this at a really large scale. I don't believe that this company has a personal responsibility to try to make light of a lot of human atrocities that happen in China. And in fact, if you look at China itself, you really almost wonder if you can fault the culture for how it is anyhow. You're talking about billions of people in one country. I mean, we don't, here in the United States, 300 million, you know, it's manageable. Everything's manageable. And so I look at things from a culture standpoint, and I think, you know, where do any of us have a personal responsibility globally, right? And that becomes like this giant question that I constantly have a battle about integrity, about, you know, social contracts, our moral standards socially, because, you know, I don't believe in moral absolutes. And I wonder where we should be, you know, like where, you know, how far we should stand up for anything. Which should we demand, you know, that they just say, you know, let's just take a chance with Doctor Strange and say, we're not going to promote this film. You know, we're not going to promote this film in China. We don't need the money, you know, and we can honor the Tibetan culture. We can honor, you know, a lot of lives lost, and we can honor the integrity of the existing comic book character. Could or should they do that? I mean, and that's the thing where I just sit there and I debate about it, because I'm not sure. I don't have a clear yes or no. It's not one of those stances where I can say, absolutely, this is how it should be, or no. And that's my question to you guys is, like, does Hollywood, do production studios, especially those that have X amount of money already and have the capital to do so, should they make a stance, right? And if how much of someone else's culture should influence the way that you produce a film? China's box office is billions of dollars, and billions of dollars is something that a lot of people, I don't really know many people who turn billions of dollars down. I just don't. I as much as people say, oh, I don't need money, I don't need anything, eventually someone always will say, well, but I could do XX and this, you know, X, Y, and Z with this money. I could do something good with it. But then in the end, you know, it's a cycle, and greed is a very powerful, it's just a powerful driving factor. And it's a tough one. And it was very interesting. So thank you guys for bringing that up to me. It's something that I'm going to think about now, and hopefully you guys give me more to think about, because again, it's one of those situations where whitewashing had occurred for a very particular and very smart business reason. And you know, I had sat there and I just thought, you know, why would they pick Tilda Swinton to play the Ancient One? It just made no sense to me. In fact, they changed the location of the temple. It's not in Tibet in Doctor Strange, the movie. You know, it's not going to be in Tibet. So it's, you know, they really are doing a lot of things in particular to appease to the Chinese market. And that's where I'm just sort of like, should they have? I mean, but then again, can you turn down billions of dollars? Can you risk billions of dollars of future revenue off of just a character that maybe can easily be replaced by a very great actress, Tilda Swinton? So, yeah, think about that. Let me know. And I'd be interested in discussing it below. And yeah. So again, thank you, and thanks for watching. And if you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my 15K subscriber Q&A, or you can click right here and watch my Lord of War review. A Lord of War. It's like Lord of War, War Dogs review. Until next time, see you on the flip side.